Welcome to the lecture on Engineering Statistics and Linear Algebra. In my previous lecture, I discussed about the continuous probability distribution. So now here I'm going to discuss about uniform distribution or rectangular distribution. So uniform distribution is also a continuous probability distribution. So uniform or rectangular distribution. A continuous random variable X is said to follow continuous uniform or rectangular distribution over an interval a comma b. Then its probability density function is given by f of x is equal to constant k for a less than x less than b, and the function will be zero otherwise. So now we'll see how to find the value of k for the uniform distribution. So we have the area of the region integration minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. So in this place, I'm going to replace the function f of x is equal to k over the interval a comma b. So I will get the function like integration a to b k dx is equal to 1. So on integrating the constant k, I'll get k into x with the limits a to b is equal to 1. So applying the limit, I will get upper limit minus lower limit, that is k into b minus a is equal to 1. So I will get k is equal to 1 minus b by a. So then f of x will be equal to 1 divided by b minus a. So I'm replacing the function f of x, k is equal to 1 by b minus a. So function will be 1 by b minus a over the interval a less than x less than b and 0 otherwise. So this is called uniform random distribution. So on plotting the graph for uniform distribution having the interval a comma b, so the plot will be like this. So taking the random variable x here and the function f of x here, so plotting the points a comma b with respect to the function 1 by b minus a, so I will get a rectangular curve like this. So now I am going to find the mean and standard deviation of the random variable x having the uniform distribution in the interval a comma b. So already we know that how to find the mean value in terms of continuous random variable. So we can call mean also as an expectation of the random variable. So the formula for mean is given by e of x is equal to integration minus infinity to plus infinity x into f of x dx. So in the place of f of x, I'm going to replace the value 1 by b minus a along the interval a comma b. So I will get the equation like the integration a to b x into 1 by b minus a into dx. Since 1 by b minus a is a constant, I can take outside. So integrating only x function between the limits a to b. So integrating x, I will get x square by 2. So keeping 1 by b minus a as it is. So now on applying the limit, so I will get upper limit minus lower limit, that is b square minus a square, I got it, into 1 by 2 into b minus a. So we know how to expand b square minus a square. So I can expand this like b plus a into b minus a. So I can cancel b minus a from the numerator and denominator. So I will get b plus a divided by 2, or mu is equal to a plus b divided by 2 is the value for the uniform distribution. So now I'm going to estimate the variance. So we can use the formula for variance like this also. Expectation of the x square minus e of x whole square. So since already we know the value of e of x from the previous mean proof, so now we need to estimate only e of x square. So the formula for e of x square is integration minus infinity to plus infinity x square f of x dx. So now we have the formula for f of x also, that is 1 by b minus a. I'm taking 1 by b minus a outside. So integrating only x square function with respect to x between the limits a to b. So integrating x square with respect to x, I will get x cube by 3. So x cube by 3 into 1 by b minus a between the limits a to b. So on applying the limit, so I will get 1 by 3 into b minus a into b cube minus a cube. So 1 by 3 into b minus a I'm keeping as it is, Expanding b cube minus a cube, I will get b minus a into b square plus ab plus a square is a formula for the expansion of b cube minus a cube. So now I can cancel b minus a with b minus a. So I got expectation of x square is b square plus ab plus a square divided by 3. So since we got the value of expectation of x square, and already from the previous proof, I'm having the value of e of x. So now I need e of x whole square. So it will be equal to b plus a whole divided by 2 whole square. I will get it. I'll call this one as equation number 2. So now v of x, the variance of the variable x, is given by e of x square minus e of x whole square. So I'm going to subtract these two equations. So I will get the equation like b square plus ab plus a square by 3 minus b plus a by 2 whole square. On expanding this equation, I will get the equation like b square plus ab plus a square divided by 3 minus b square plus 2ab plus a square by 4. So on this equation, by taking LCM, we'll get the equation like 4b square plus 4ab plus 4a square minus 3b square minus 6ab minus 3a square. So on simplifying this complete equation, I'll get the equation like b square minus 2ab minus a square divided by 12. This whole thing will be equal to, it will be plus a square actually here. So this whole thing will be equal to b minus a whole square divided by 12 is the value of the variance. Similarly, we know how to find the standard deviation. The standard deviation is given by square root of variance. So since variance will be equal to b minus a whole square divided by 2, so squaring that value, I will get the value of standard deviation is b minus a divided by square root of 12. So one example on the uniform distribution. So consider the uniformly distributed random variables has the PDF of f of x is equal to 1 for 0 less than x and less than 1 for 0 otherwise. So calculate its mean square value and its variance. So here the given function is f of x is equal to 1 and the interval is given by 0 to 1. So we know how to estimate the function. Actually, function is given by 1 by b minus a. So if I choose b is equal to 1 and a is equal to 0 here. So if I replace in the formula f of x is equal to 1 by b minus a, the condition will be satisfied. So I will get 1 only. So I can choose this function as a uniform distribution function from the given interval. So now to calculate mean square and its variance, I am going to use a is equal to 0 and b is equal to 1. So as I told that, I am taking b is equal to 1 and a is equal to 0. In the PDF, I am going to replace the value of b is equal to 1 and a is equal to 0. So I will get the equation 1 here. The condition gets satisfied for the PDF function. So now let me calculate the value of mean. So mean is given by b plus a divided by 2. So replacing the value of b is equal to 1 and a is equal to 0 divided by 2, I will get the value is 1 by 2. So similarly, mean square, e of x square is equal to a square plus ab plus b square divided by 3. So it will be equal to 0 plus 0 plus 1 divided by 3. So answer will be 1 by 3. So variance is given by sigma x square or vx is equal to a minus b whole square, or we can take b minus a whole square by 12 also. So on replacing the values of a and b, I'll get the value of minus 1 whole square divided by 12. So answer will be 1 by 12. Thank you.